Hi, I'm Rick Emerson, and welcome back to Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. We're joined today by Mr. Kurt Lloyd, the man behind the program Super Atomic TV, and now Missing Reel, which is going to be broadcast via Coldcast. And when I say Coldcast, I don't know what counts as a network, what counts as a channel, what counts as an app. Are we in a place where those terms no longer apply?
I think they still apply. They're just modified. A channel is a destination to find programming, whereas a network is an entity that disseminates programming. Coldcast obviously has a channel that you can find them on a lot of set-top boxes. If you have a Roku or even, I don't know if they're in the PlayStation Network, even though that's down now. They're in on different formats. The set-top box boom is huge for digital media.
Is that a thing that's going to persist? Or is it all?
You know, I think it has to. We were talking earlier before the show about Netflix, and I'm sure we'll get back around to it. But Netflix themselves, 24 million subscribers, and heading in a direction where they want to do streaming only eventually, because DVDs will be a dead format like VHS. And in order to stream that content through the internet and watch it on your big, beautiful 52-inch HD TV, you need a device that's connected to the internet and your television. And not everybody has gaming systems, especially folks 35 plus don't have gaming systems. A lot of families want to have, they'll have their Wii in their living room, but somebody will want to watch a show in the other room. And inexpensive set-top boxes, where a couple of years ago people thought that idea was dead, are booming. They're huge. Over Christmas, Consumer Reports talked about that being one of the biggest growth areas in electronics. And the Roku, the Boxy that came out this last fall, all of those very inexpensive. Price point for a Roku, I think, going in is $60. And besides your Netflix and your Hulu Plus, you've got Coldcast, you've got Blip TV, you've got Crackle, all these digital networks now have actual channels that are available to click on and use like you would your cable box.
In the mid-late 90s, everybody was a web page designer. Right now, everybody's an app designer.
Sure.
They'll tell you they're an app designer. Probably within 2 or 3 years, everybody's going to be a content producer to some degree. Everybody is going to be uploading more and more of their lives or creating more and more original content for the net, regardless of how good or bad that content may be. Is it going to become more and more difficult to distinguish yourself or to stand out as a content provider as everybody begins to do that to some degree?
I think that you will always see quality programming float to the top. YouTube has a program that they just launched where they had people upload video clips to kind of show what they could do as an independent producer, and then they selected 10 of those and sent them to USC Film School for a month's worth of intensive study on how to produce quality content. There are other networks that are doing the same, digital networks doing the same thing, where they're trying to put good gear and good practice in the hands of some of their better producers so that you'll have kind of socially tiered content. You'll always have people uploading bits and pieces of their lives and moving that into the fabric of social media. But you'll have kind of an HBO quality level of independent programming that will float to the top. And you could probably access them from the same location, but you'll always have places that you can go to and see. You will eliminate pictures of your three-year-old dancing in his underwear to a Neil Diamond song, and you'll just simply focus on some quality programming. Coldcast is one of those.
Is that content going to, is it going to remain, in your opinion, largely cost-free? I mean, to the end user. Right now, we still seem to be in the ad-supported model for a lot of streaming online content. Is that going to change?
Monetization is still something that people are trying to figure out. The audience is there. The method of distribution is there. How they monetize that, how they pay people, that ad model, ad-supported model, is working, but not working to the degree that it's going to make anybody a ton of money. So they're still trying to figure out ways to do that. I think what you're going to end up with is you will have your YouTubes, but you will also have, let's say YouTube in a couple of years decides we're going to have a tier of programming that is top-notch, quality, well-produced shows, even if it's produced independently, that we will then license to another distributor. Netflix getting into the licensed original content business. And I think they're going to challenge the HBO model by making it all on demand. And so you'll probably find content networks licensing out some of their top-tier programming to a Netflix. And that money will, Netflix will pay for that money, that programming up front. And then that money will come back down to the producer.
Actually, it's a good point to put a pin in this. We will continue this conversation when we come back. You are watching Outlook Portland right here on Northwest 32 TV. Don't go anywhere.